Hi, I'm Pete.
Hello, I'm Michael.
And today we're going to talk about filtering in LMS Test Lab. Here we got some data. Looks a little bit noisy, like we have some high frequency noise. So what can we do about that?
We can apply a filter to this data. I'd recommend maybe using a low pass filter.
A low pass?
Yeah, a low pass gets rid of the high frequencies, which you can see in the graph.
So here I am in the conditioning and time signal calculator. We have some different filter, band pass, band stop, high pass, here's a low pass. So we'll do a low pass.
And the first thing we're going to want to do in this low pass filter is make the function channel 7.
Oh, like here?
Yeah, cause that's where all our data is. Make the frequency 500 and the filter type can go to FIR and order 100 seems fine for now.
Oh yeah? So that's what our filter looks like. It's going to keep everything below 500 here and then try and get rid of everything above 500. And we're hoping to remove some of that high frequency noise. I'll give it a new ID here. And hit calculate. Let's see what we got. What do you think? Did we get rid of the noise?
It's a bit hard to tell. Can we overlay those two graphs?
Sure.
Yeah, so it looks like we did get rid of some of them. What if we try to lower the frequency?
Lower the frequency. So what do you mean? The cutoff frequency here?
Yeah, lower the cutoff frequency to maybe 5.
5? Wow, that's pretty aggressive, Michael. Look, now we're going to be cutting out a lot of frequency content, huh?
Yeah.
Look at that a little bit closer. All right. I'll hit calculate. Ooh.
Yeah, it does look a little bit better, but it's still really noisy. What if we increase the amount of orders we have, making the filter sharper, letting less data go through?
So the order will be, if we increase the order, it'll make it sharper.
Yeah.
So not as gradual of a roll-off. What should we bump it up to?
2,000?
2,000. That looks a lot sharper than it was. All right. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's sharp.
Looks really good, except I'm seeing some delay there.
Delay?
Yeah, so if you zoom in.
Let me zoom in, yeah. Oh, I see what you're talking about. You got all this kind of high frequency stuff, and it looks like the sine wave is now lagging where it was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can we use a zero phase filter to put the data in twice and then...
Zero phase?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, there's an option here for zero phase. It puts the data in twice, you said?
Yeah, forward and backwards to get rid of that time delay.
And gets rid of that. Let's see. I'll hit calculate here. Oh yeah, now that's nicely aligned. That's cool. Now I think at the end you lose a little bit of data because it got forward and backward, but at least everything's aligned in time. So that's pretty good. So yeah, nice job, Michael.
We can improve this, making it less computationally intense.
Less computationally intense. What's the benefit of that?
Well, if you have a slower machine, we can go through this data a lot faster.
Huh. So what would make it less computationally intense?
By making the type an IIR filter.
So instead of an FIR with an order of 2,000, we're going to switch it to IIR here?
With an order of 10.
And how much did we reduce the calculations by?
We reduced the calculations by about 200.
Factor of 200?
Yeah.
Versus, because we had 2,000 and now we have 10. The data didn't change at all. I guess that's what we wanted. We did that calculation 200 times faster.
Yes.
Cool.
Cool.